When the river water is available for our use, we land in a confusion to drink it or not. It's all because of the hardness of water. Normally the rainwater is soft, but when it flows through rivers and other water bodies, it gets mixed with rocks or soil. As a result of it, calcium, magnesium, and other mineral ions change the hard water into soft water. But in the soft water, mostly you can find soluble sodium ions. As mentioned previously, when it rains on the Earth's surface, the rainwater remains as a soft water source. Due to the presence of various minerals on the Earth's surface, the hardness of water is caused, which initially might be a temporary hardness, due to the presence of dissolved carbonates of calcium and magnesium. A while later, it becomes permanent hardness due to the presence of sulfates, chlorides, nitrates, and other heavy ions. Hardness of the water is measured by grains per gallon, parts per million, and milligrams per liter. It's always good to have a river near our home. If you are going to use that river water for your drinking purpose, you will be in a state whether the water would taste good enough, as it might be salty. So we have to remove the salts present in the water. But how to remove it? EDTA is one of the chemicals used for this purpose, and it is a complex reagent. Because water hardness is the amount of dissolved calcium and magnesium in the water. In this process, a metal ion indicator called EBT is used. EBT initially combines with calcium and magnesium ions to give a red-colored complex reagent. When all the calcium and magnesium ions have reacted with the complex reagent EDTA, the blue color of the uncombined EBT marks the endpoint of magnesium. Finally, we removed the salts present in the water. Most of the industries would function near the river banks. In these kind of industries, boilers would be used. Here, the purpose of the boilers is to generate steam by heating up the water. During this process, a collection of sludges, scales, and boiler corrosion are formed. Sludge is a semi-solid substance formed by small quantities of hardness and the traces of remaining matter present within the boiler. If that matter precipitates and forms a hard layer on the inner walls of the boiler, then it is known as scales.